Hi there. In this video, we're going to learn to type in the chemical formulae in InDesign, so let's get started. I already have some of the formulae typed in here, so I'm going to ensure that nothing is selected, and then click the small plus button at the bottom of the character styles panel to create a style. Double-click the new style and rename it superscript. So basically, I need the charges to be superscripted, which means a little raised from the baseline. Let's go to Basic Character Formats, and in the Position drop-down list, select either Superscript or OpenType Superscript. Both should work just fine, and hit OK. Similarly, create another character style and rename it Subscript. We'll need this for the valencies. Now go to Basic Character Formats tab, and from the Position drop-down menu, select Subscript or OpenType Subscript and hit OK. Time to move on to paragraph styles, so click the small plus button at the bottom of the paragraph styles panel and then double click the new style and rename it should you want to. I'll keep it as it is. Let's click the GREP Style tab on the left and then click New GREP Style. From the Apply Style drop-down, select Superscript character style that we created a few moments ago. Click the two text option and type in these symbols without any spaces. That's backslash, then open parenthesis, then another backslash, then the letter D, then the asterisk sign, then another parenthesis, then a backslash, then a hyphen, then pipe, then another backslash, then a plus sign, then close parenthesis, then a backslash, and finally close parenthesis. You don't have to remember that. That's why I just copied and pasted here, because even I don't remember that. So once you've fed the code in, click New GREP Style to create another one. From the Apply Style drop-down, select Subscript Character Style that we created a few moments ago. Click the two text option and type in these symbols without any spaces. That's open parenthesis, then a question mark, then less than sign, then equal sign, then open bracket, then a capital A, then a hyphen, then a capital Z, then closed bracket, then pipe, then open bracket, then a lowercase a, then a hyphen, then a lowercase z, then closed bracket, then closed parenthesis, then a backslash, then the letter D, then open brace, then one, then a comma, then two, and finally, closed brace. Like I mentioned earlier, you don't have to remember that. That's why even I just copied and pasted here, because even I don't remember that. So once you've fed the code in, click OK. Now select the text box and then click the paragraph style you've just created, and you've got yourself the chemical formulae typed in InDesign. Let's add some leading space and we are done. Alright guys, that's all for now. I'm going to see you in the next one pretty soon. Goodbye.